What's up, Laker fans? The Lakers acquired Jose Calderon and 2 second round picks from the Bulls this summer. Let's take a look at his game and see how he fits in with the team. The thing that stood out to me the most about Calderon's game is how cautious he is. The positive side of that is that he makes very few turnovers, but I also think that he leaves some points on the court because he's not aggressive at times. Take this play for example. He's just come around a double drag screen and now his defender's behind him. Most guards are going to attack this space to see if they can get this defender or this defender to commit, so then they can have a drive and dish or drive and kick opportunity. He doesn't do that and pulls back instead. He's a really good shooter, but doesn't even look for his own shot despite the fact that his man is in the paint. So with that idea in mind that he's very selective when he attacks, he's very good at it when he does. He knows he's not going to finish very often amongst the trees in the paint, so he's good at keeping his dribble alive and finding shooters open in the corner. More set plays, he does a good job of getting the ball to shooters right as they arrive at their spot and in their shot pocket. This creates nice open looks that aren't there for long. He's good at reading when the shooter is going to curl as well. Aflalo doesn't do anything with this, but Jordan Clarkson would. I also like that he reads the defense rather than robotically making the pass. Here he sees that the defense is overplayed to the strong side, so he swings it back to Porzingis for an open jumper. He's got great touch on his lob passes as well. It should be fun watching him play with Nance and Mozgov. He has a ton of experience both in the NBA and internationally, so he knows how to read every pick and roll coverage there is. He does a nice job of understanding the skill set of the guys that he plays with. Westbrook ices this, but Lopez isn't a pick and pop threat, so Calderon leads him to the basket instead. Keeping his dribble alive also creates some open looks for him. I'd love to see him pass this down to D'Angelo Russell. He has an excellent pull-up jump shot, which he almost always shoots while going left. He reminds me a lot of Sadale Threed in that respect, if you're old enough to remember him. Calderon is one of the best spot-up shooters in the league. He shot over 41% from three-point range in each of the last four seasons. His form is very quiet, compact, and repeatable, and he finishes very well off of the shot creation of others. Even though he's a point guard, you can play him off-ball as a result. I was pleasantly surprised by his abilities as a screener, where he really seeks out contact. Here he frees up Porzingis on a split cut, which is an action that I expect the Lakers to run a lot of next year. I don't have too many nice things to say about his defense, but let's start with a couple of things that he does well. When he goes over the top of a screen, as you would on a soft hedge, he does a good job of staying attached to the point guard. Ideally, you want to pressure from behind without fouling, and he does that. But his lack of foot speed and agility is a real problem. On these next few, he's going under screens on Goran Dragic, and the entire point of going under a screen is to give up the jump shot, but keep your man from driving to the basket. But he's still not quick enough to cut Dragic off, even with the advantage of going under the screen. Dragic gets deep enough into the paint to occupy a second defender, leading to an open shot. This is also problematic because it forces you to switch even when you might not want to. On this one, he's not quick enough to get over or under Trey Lyles' screen, so they end up switching. Neto puts up a wild shot, but Calderon isn't nearly big enough to keep Lyles off of the boards. This is an issue in man-to-man defense as well. He has a hard time staying in front of even guys who don't drive to the basket that well. So he's not going to have any chance against the better point guards in the Western Conference. And lastly, he's only able to defend the point guard position. If he gets caught in transition or on a switch, he's in deep trouble. Calderon is a low-volume, high-efficiency player who can really help your offense, but his defensive issues can be problematic.